Good morning from Okinawa, Japan. I'm Oki Sivi. Today, in this video, we're going to show you how to make rear hybrid axles using Super Dave's special races. Stay tuned. If you remember back, we did a transmission swap. It was the easiest 6-speed transmission swap video we did a while back on a Type RA STI. And that's because they already come stock with the R180 rear diffs. So it's literally plug and play. You swap the rear diff with the final drive that matches the front transmission and you're good. In that video, we mentioned a couple different ways that you could do the 6-speed swap. And one of them was creating hybrid axles for the rear. That way, you don't have to change your hubs. You don't have to change the rear end or any of that. You just simply take the stock drive shaft that comes in the car. You purchase Dave's custom races, which then allows you to use the portion that goes into the stock GC8 hub or WRX in America if it's 5x100. And then you can use the shaft, the side of the half shaft that goes into the rear diff. That custom race allows you to use this part that goes into the R180, and this part that goes into the stock hub, and then you create one from two. And so this video, we're going to just break down how to do it. So step number one,
I think,
is going to be to disassemble the half shaft that came out of the car, out of the GC. And so when doing that, there's a couple tools that we like to use. A hammer just to help us assist, but this flathead screwdriver with a small tip, really necessary. A pair of diagonal side cutters, and then a snap ring pliers. So first things first, working on the half shaft that came out of the GC, just want to drive the screwdriver in between these little holding clips, and then using the diagonal side cutters, whatever you call them. Kind of separate them so it frees clamp. Okay. These clamps are pretty difficult to get tight without a special tool, but we do our best. Yeah, so with those open, you want to slide them off of the boot, allowing you to move and maneuver the boot.
Please.
You guys, if you didn't know, I don't like getting dirty. And this is one of the dirtiest jobs. I hate this job. Doing boots in general, and boots tear. This sucks. Okay, so now that the boot has slid back, revealing all this goo, we need to get a C-clip. So there's a C-clip that holds this portion onto the half shaft. And so, with a rag, that's going to be just unusable after it's done. You'll wipe out the grease, revealing a C-clip. Let's see if we can see the C-clip. You can see it right there. So this right here is a little C-clip. So you're going to wipe away, using this rag, you're going to wipe away this grease, trying to find the end of the C-clip, if you can find it. And there, I think this is it right here. Yeah, there it is. So once you find it, you just pull it out of its groove and the whole thing will come out. We won't need this one. And I'll go through the parts that you will need from each drive shaft, but we won't need this one anymore because the end that's going to be driving, sliding back onto this half shaft will be from the GD. So with that out of the way, this slides right off, revealing all the balls. So here's all the balls that sit inside this cage. Pretty awesome, whoever invented this thing, how they decided to make it work. So I just take all the balls and set them to the side. We won't need these anymore. And then the next C-clip, we have to unveil. is right here. At the end, if you can see this, there's a C clip right there. And so now you'll use snap ring pliers. Now I'd suggest using both hands because you can't determine really predict where this thing's gonna go. Yeah. And then we will keep this for the reinstallation. So we'll keep that. The C clip that held on this, we'll throw away. This will slide off. I'll throw it away. I don't need it. And I don't need the cage anymore. Now, when ordering custom races from Dave, there's two things that you have to count. Dave wants to know two things from you guys. One is the spline count on the GC side. So you have to make a mark and then count all of the splines until you know how many is this there. That's a number that you'll have to keep in mind. Secondly, on the GD half shaft, he wants to know how many balls are inside the cage. The custom race that he sends, if it's an 8-ball or a 6-ball, if you have an earlier GD, it might have 6 balls. For us, we use the GR half shaft, so they have 8 balls, and so we tell them it's going to be a 36 spline or 38 spline with 6 balls or 8 balls, and then he makes sure to send us the right one, right? So this is the custom race that's going on to the GC8 half shaft, allowing us to utilize the GD side. So after removing this portion from the GC8 half shaft, you will then repeat those same steps on the GR side or GD side of the half shaft. So with the C clip off, I was able to slide this off, right, just like on the last one, and then it reveals there's 8 balls now, right? So we're gonna save these and reuse them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, right? So 8個ある. So this is what we would have sent to Dave's race, custom races. Okay, and this is the cage too. Pay attention to the orientation of the cage, right? It tapers down like this. So when we put it on over there, you don't want to flop it. Again, revealing the C-clip, snap ring, whatever you want to call it, here on the end of the shaft, using your handy dandy C-clip pliers, snap ring pliers. You'll get it off there just like that, and we will not use this one because the diameter of this shaft is bigger than that one, so this one won't help us out. We'll put that to the side. Okay, and then we'll slide this off. We won't need this. We will not slide that off. We will hammer that bad boy off. That's why I have this hammer. Give it a little tap. Don't worry, we won't reuse this, so no worries if it gets damaged. Sayonara. We will use the cage. So, slide the cage on. Dave's custom race. Put this bad boy on. No orientation on it. Slides directly on, no problem. The snap ring from earlier, from the GC universe. Put it on. Using the snap ring pliers. Make sure it slides in that groove. Yeah, there it goes. Give it a good tug. Then the cage will slide up, and then you'll put the balls in individually. This is a little difficult. Sometimes the balls can be aggravating and not want to cooperate. But you'll put them in as many as you can on one side. There you go, this is it. Also, the surface that you're working on should be clean. I'm using cardboard, clean cardboard. You don't want to be dropping these in the dirt. If you do, just clean them well. All right, so now that my wrist looks all broken like that, we will hold them in and then slide this bad boy over top, just like that. You see that? Magic. And then, using the C-clip that holds the cage in, slide it over. Slide it into its groove, push it in with a couple tugs on it to make sure it's good. Dave also includes these bags of grease Don't skimp out. You want to put the whole bag inside of the boot before sliding the boot back onto the outer portion of the R180. Yeah, that's some good junk right there, I tell you. Don't worry. That's just what it's supposed to do. It's supposed to look like. It's for the best, because it's so messy. All right, so the last and final step is to install the clamps that Super Dave includes in his kit. And as they just slide over, one, the big side goes here, the small side goes there. You'll use the special tool that you'd have to buy from Harbor Freight, or here it's called Astro Tools, Astro Products. You'd buy from there, make sure it's good and tight. But all in all, that is how you would do a hybrid axle using Super Dave's Custom Races. Hope this helped. If there's anything you need clarified, just ask in the comment section. We'd be more than happy to answer your questions. This is a special car. We're excited to feature it. One of the things that we wanted to do was put these hybrid axles in, and then once it's all said and done, cleaned up, we'll show you what we did. Okay, guys. From Okie Subies, have a good day. Thanks for watching.